God is what our hearts desire to be overcome by your presence, Lord. Your presence, Lord. Yes, we want your presence.
Shame is undone.
We want your presence.
Your presence, Lord.
Holy Spirit, welcome.
Holy Spirit, you are welcome here. Come flood this place and fill the
are welcome.
And looking at things that are going on and wondering why things are going on the way that they're going on. But then, I'm sorry, let me get to the scripture for you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. In verse 2, it said, "But as for me, my feet had almost stumbled. My steps had nearly slipped." And then it goes on to say, "For I was envious of the boastful." And it talks about how he was watching other people who don't honor God seem to prosper. And then it said, it was too painful for me in verse 16. He said, "When I thought how to understand this, it was too painful for me." But verse 17 says, "Until I went into the sanctuary of God." Amen. Hallelujah. He said, "Then I understood their end." But then at the same time, when God was just showing me how when we are in his presence, when we are yielded to him, when we're trusting him and him alone, he's the one who makes it clear for us. He's the one who brings hope. He's the one who, you know, may help you to understand. And there's some people and there's some things that God need to help you to understand this morning. He said, "God, give me clarity on it." And so your heart might have been displaced. Your thoughts may have been displaced. And you're trying to, you know, work some things out, even as the word said. You're trying to understand some things. And my heart was just even breaking this morning as I thought of those who fellowship with God and who walk with God. But today, because they tried to do things on their own and tried to heal a hurt on their own and tried to fix a wrong on their own and tried to find another way to make it happen, and now they are separated from the things of God. But the Spirit of the Lord wants you to know this morning, and I believe he's spoken by his word, and as we just yield and surrender to that this morning, Father, we just yield. And you know, and you may be having that struggle. I've been trying to figure this out. I've been trying to work this out. And my heart's been getting sad because I'm looking to see how other people seem to be doing. And I'm not doing. But God has said this morning, you know, if that's you, said, Lord, I'm just going to put my eyes back on you. We just repent. Just take a moment right there and say, Lord, I repent. If that word was for you, either of those words. Lord, I've been trying to, you know, trying to do stuff on my own. And the word might seem tough and the word might seem tight, but we are mature people. Amen. And God's going to deal with you like a mature person. And he's going to talk to you like a mature person. And he's saying, get your eyes right. Get your heart back in the right place. Put your trust back in me. He's our only source. He's not a source. He is the source. He's all I have. Amen. If it had not been for the Lord, where would I be at this moment? Amen. And we stand here by your grace. So, and if that's you, so you know what? I've been having a struggle and a battle right there. But today, I'm just going to trust you, Lord. I'm repenting of trying to do it myself. Let's just take that moment. Lord, we just repent of anything we tried to put our hands to, Father. Anything we've not trusted you to fully do, Lord God. Father, because you are faithful, Lord God. Father, I cast off every thought. Right now, somebody needs to cast off thoughts that have been bought in your mind, trying to make you consider something else. There is no plan B. There is no option. As for me, it's God and God alone. There is no option. You need to tell it out of your heart. Let yourself hear you say it. There's no other plan for me. There's no other option for me. It's God and God alone. So, Lord, we step into righteousness. So as we have just repented, if we needed to and anything, so we just step right back into righteousness. We step back into your way of doing things, oh God. I'm stepping fully, Lord God, putting both of my feet, yeah, both of your feet, not one of them, hallelujah, not one of your hands. We need to have both. When you're in a car, you got to have both feet in and both hands in, especially if you're driving, amen. You can, if you have one in and one of them out, you're in trouble. You got to have both your feet in the car if it's in motion. So, Father, we put all of ourselves back into you, Lord. We come into alignment with you and with your word, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God. We live righteousness, righteously, Lord God, from this moment forward. I thank you, Lord God, that as I'm even here in the sanctuary, you're helping me to understand the things that I've not understood. Father, let understanding, yes, let understanding come to your people. Let understanding come right now. I bind the spirit of confusion right now in the name of Jesus Christ. I cast off every cloud, Lord God. I thank you for a fresh wind of the spirit blowing away even clouds, Lord God, of confusion and chaos right now in Jesus' name. I thank you for clarity of thought, Lord God, clarity of hearing right now in the name of Jesus. And I thank you, Lord God, for new, Lord God, fresh fire coming up, Lord God, even out of their belly, Lord God, in Jesus' name. Thank you for a connection right now. I see the socket going into the plug, into the wall. Connection. I'm reconnecting right now in Jesus' name. I'm connecting to the things of God. I'm connecting fully to the purpose and the plan of God. I'm connecting fully to the voice of God in Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus, I thank you for it. Father, we give you glory and we give you honor. We thank you for your grace this morning. If you're thankful for his grace, just tell him thank you for your grace, Lord. Lord, I thank you for your grace that you extend to me, Lord God. Thank you for that in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen, amen, amen. Tell your neighbor the grace of God looks good on you. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. You can be seated in his presence if you'd like to. Hallelujah. I'm so grateful for God, for his mercy, amen, for his grace. And when I tell you it's sufficient, amen, hallelujah. When I tell you it's good, amen, hallelujah. We lack nothing, amen, we lack absolutely nothing, amen. We want you to know we love you this morning, and we pray God's best and his blessed is making his way to us. We have all over the sanctuary. Amen. If you're joining us on social media, we pray that the spirit of the Lord is ministering to you there. I want to encourage you. Amen. Just keep your spirit open to the spirit of God. Amen. To what he's saying and what he's doing. Because God is so good. I've learned he can take one word and do 10 different things with it. Amen. So hallelujah. I want you to appropriate the word this morning. Amen. Appropriate the word. Amen. I'm going to put that right there. Amen. Hallelujah. I watched this little game show. The people, they gambling, but I just like to watch it to see they try to play 21. you know, and so they have to decide, oh, I got a 2, I'm going to put it over here. I got a 5, I'm going to put it over here, you know, and whatever. So, I mean, you got to decide what you're going to do with the word. Amen. Make a decision about what you're going to do with the word. Amen. It determines whether you win or lose. Amen. Hallelujah. Appropriate the word of God this morning. Don't shut your ears down because you thought, oh, that's talking about. No, allow the Spirit of God to make it clear to you. Amen. David said, I would have slipped. I almost fainted. I was about to give up, but I went to the sanctuary. Amen. You in the sanctuary this morning. Amen. Are you in the sanctuary? We are under the dew of heaven. Amen. We are in the place where the Spirit of God is speaking to us. And by His Spirit, by His grace, you know, I'm telling you, I'm just so grateful for all that the Spirit of the Lord is doing this morning. We want you to know we love you. Amen. If you're visiting with us for the first time in the house, we'd love to see your hand, give you a warm Westgate welcome. Any first-time visitors in the house? Going once, going twice, we all at home, amen. Hallelujah. Well, if you're joining us online, amen, we want you to know we love you. Anybody in-house, online, if you ever find yourselves in need of pastoral care, please reach out to us and let us know. We want to be there with you, amen, and walk with you through whatever's going on. I want to personally thank you all for just your prayer and your love, amen, over the past couple of weeks as we celebrated Grandmama's life. Amen. And we in the natural had a homegoing celebration yesterday, but she left on June 30th. Amen. She stepped out of this place and over into the presence of the Lord. And I'm telling you, I could just see her, amen, enjoying the Lord. And just with that sweet disposition of hers and that smile, y'all know how she would come in. She tell everybody, I love you, you know. And I'm telling you, and even yesterday, it just really kind of came clear to me, a little clearer to me, just how prophetic, you know, her walk was. She wasn't one that walked around and said, thus said the Lord, and quoting the scripture, amen, but it just emanated from her life, amen. And I wondered, I think I told you guys, when she was in the hospital, and the little doctor, you know, and she told him, I love you. And she took her hand. He said, oh, she's so sweet. I said, yes, yeah, she took her hand and she laid hands on him. She said, oh, I love you. She kept telling him, I love you. Now you just keep on doing what God's called you to do because I love you. Amen. I'll just smile. She told him, oh, you know, she was just, and that little guy, I think he needed ministry when he learned that Grandmama was about to start transitioning on up out of here. Just that quickly, you never know. Amen. And her life was well lived. Amen. Unto the glory of God. Hallelujah. And we are thankful to the Lord for that. And amen. So she wouldn't come back here if she could. Amen. Hallelujah. So we are so glad. I'm happy for her. Amen. Our hearts are catching up. Amen. Our emotions are catching up to our spirit. Amen. So we thank you for your continued love. You all are so very sweet. I'm telling you, every text message and every call and every little post and, you know, the flowers, the prayers, oh, my God, the prayers have held us. Amen. And we know that it's there. We know that you're there. And Pastor Al knows that you guys love him big time. Amen. So thank you for all that you've done. When I tell you, you've helped his heart, and I mean it. Amen. So hallelujah. Thank you for that. Amen. Yeah, and you say, ooh, we love each other, amen. We showed it, amen. Hallelujah. So you guys, now I want you guys to know on this Tuesday, we're going to have a special little youth meeting. Y'all see Tim and Krista out enjoying their honeymoon like somebody that told them they could miss church or something. I don't know. But this Tuesday, amen, we're going to have a special youth meeting. On this Tuesday, so I want to encourage all these young people to come out. Bring some young people with you. I'm going to have somebody there to talk with them about this little thing that's going on still in their lives. Amen. And how the enemy is using drugs and what they don't think is this or that. Amen. So I'm going to bring somebody in who can talk to them about that. Amen. And so I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be good. So I want you to encourage any young people you have, you know, the youth from ages, I think, 13 to 8, whatever age, amen. Y'all come on out and encourage them to come out. So we're going to start. They enjoy our time, play the little games and all the stuff they have there, and then we're going to see how God will help have us to have this engaging time. Amen. It's going to be an open time of exchange and engaging, and just because if you don't have right information, you cannot make right decisions. Amen. You can't make right decisions on wrong information. And so it's important that they know, and they're going to hear it from somebody who loves them, somebody who's born again and spirit-filled. Amen. But trained and knowledgeable and able to talk to them about this stuff. Amen. Hallelujah. Because we don't tell them one thing. The enemy and the people in the world are telling them something else. And these children are dying and taking their own lives unintentionally because they're listening to people who don't know. Amen. And so we're going to just take the tool away one piece at a time. Amen. Hallelujah. We're going to give them the word. We've got the spiritual thing to back it up and all that good stuff, but we're going to give them the information in their hands. Hallelujah. There's one thing I've learned. Children will grab what they think they know and run tell. You know, that's why many of the young people are engaged in homosexuality right now, because they're listening to children, you know, and they're teaching things they don't know, and they're spreading misinformation. So let's give them the right information, and then they can go run tell that. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. All right. So we good? 7 o'clock this Tuesday night, New Image in the annex. All right. We continue to have our time of intercessory prayer. Ladies, we want you to put on your calendar for July 23rd. I believe we're planning a ladies meeting. We're going to have a paint party. Hallelujah. Amen. So we'll give you some more information as we get a little closer to it. Amen. I think that's it. We're going to move on with our offering right now. I know I kind of jumped over our declaration. Y'all forgive me again. Amen. Hallelujah. Let's put our offering scripture up. Amen. Come on, Angel. You want to come read? You hold it down. Get your mama's mic. All right, we're going to read our offering scripture together, and then after that, we'll do our declaration, and then you can bring your tithe and offering, and don't feel under any pressure. You guys know that. Amen. To give, allow the Lord to speak to you about what you do. Amen. Go ahead, baby.
Remember this. A farmer who plants only a few seeds will get a small crop, but the one who plants generously will get a generous crop. You must each decide in your heart how much to give. And don't give reluctantly or in response to pressure, for God loves a person who gives cheerfully. And God will generously provide all I need, then I will always have everything I need and plenty left over to share with others.
Amen. I'll do the declaration. You ready? This is my tithe
and my seed.
I purposed in my heart to give it today. I am a cheerful giver. From this day, all of God's grace will abound to me. Because I give cheerfully, I will always have
all sufficiency in all things.
And now, may the God of heaven, who supplied this seed I now sow, and bread to eat for food, do what? And everybody that believes it said,
amen.
Amen and amen. Hallelujah.
It's your season to be blessed. God made you a promise. You stood the test. Windows of heaven pour you out a blessing. It's your season to be blessed.
It's your season.
It's your season
to be blessed.
God made you a promise.
God made you a promise.
You stood
the test. Windows of heaven. Pour you out a blessing.
Pour you out a blessing.
It's your season.
It's your season
to be blessed.
You're blessed in the city. You're blessed in the field. You're blessed going out, and you're blessed coming in. He's gonna open the windows and pour you out a blessing. It's your season to be blessed.
It's your season.
It's your season
to be blessed.
God made you a promise.
God made you a promise.
You stood
the test. windows of heaven.
Windows of heaven.
Pour you out a blessing.
Pour you out a blessing.
It's your season.
It's your season.
To be blessed.
I've been through the fire. I've been through the flood. Yeah. I'm standing here today, all because of his blood. He's gonna open the windows and pour you out a blessing. It's your season to be blessed.
It's your season.
It's your season
to be blessed.
God made you a promise.
God made you a promise.
You stood
the test. Windows of heaven.
Windows of heaven.
Pour you out a blessing.
Pour you out a blessing.
It's your season.
It's your season.
It's your season.
Don't give up.
It's your season.
It's your season.
It's your season.
Don't give in.
It's your season.
Don't look back.
It's your season.
It's your season.
It's your season.
Yes.
To be blessed.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. We serve an awesome God.
Thank you,
we
Jesus.
We serve an awesome God, church.
Yes, Lord. Yes, yes,
hallelujah.
Yes.
Hallelujah. The splendor of a king, clothed in majesty. Let all the earth rejoice. Let all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light. And darkness tries to hide and tremble at his voice, and tremble at his voice. How great is our God. Sing with me, how great is our God. All will see how great. How great is our God. Hallelujah. Age to age, he stands. Oh, and time is in his hands. Beginning and the end. Beginning and the end.
And all will see how great, how
We're so thankful. We're so grateful. And Father, we thank you for the precious Holy Spirit that is present with us this morning. Precious Holy Spirit, we honor you. You are the most important person on this side of heaven. And continue to be so honored in our midst. Father, we're so thankful for the precious, precious Holy Spirit. We ask that you'll continue to move like you want to move and do like you want to do. Our hearts are open to you. Don't be grieved or hindered or vexed or quenched or be rejected, but precious Holy Spirit, take your liberty to speak to us and to minister to us, to touch us. We honor you. And Father, we do love you with all of our heart, all of our mind, all of our soul, and all of our strength. Father, we love our neighbors as we love ourselves. Ooh, Lord, we love each other. We thank you for that love that's been expressed through our hearts toward each other, that the world would know that we belong to you and that we've been translated out of the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of your dear Son. Lord Jesus, we only have eyes for you. We're in love with you. Neither silver, gold, nor life itself can satisfy. Only you can satisfy us. We have what we have. We are what we are. We're gone because of you, precious, precious Lord Jesus. And Father, we ask this morning that you will continue to bless our time together and give us a very fruitful time. And as we stand in your presence, seated in your presence, we are open to you, to your love. We're open to you that you will continue to bring ministry to us. Our eyes are on you. Our hearts are lifted toward you. Lord, even in our times together, we dig deep into you, Lord. And we thank you, Lord, for the treasure of wisdom coming unto us. That, Lord God Almighty, that we will continue to represent you and how you will do things in the earth. We're so thankful and so grateful, Lord, that you chose us and called us. We thank you for the anointing upon our lives to do all that you call us to do. We thank you, Lord, that we can walk in obedience and see the supernatural move of God. Everywhere we go, people will recognize that we have something that others don't have, that we're running on something, and that we're filled with something that the world does not have a clue. But Lord, we thank you. By faith, we live this life. And all those who want to experience this life, they have to live it by faith. And we thank you, Lord Jesus, for all what you're doing in the hearts and lives of your precious, precious people. Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for the anointing. Thank you for the precious Holy Spirit. Come on, right there where you are. I want you to say with me, thank God for the Holy Ghost. Come on, say it again. Thank God for the Holy Ghost. Amen. Amen. Y'all anointed. Thank y'all. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Come on, say thank God for the Holy Ghost again. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The Lord is absolutely good. And amen. What we are experiencing is all who God is and being in Christ. Being in Christ. Come on, say, be in Christ. Say it again, be in Christ. That means something, hallelujah. That means you open yourself up to receive all that God has for you. Every time you say, I'm in Christ, I'm in Christ. You can't get no other way. There is no other way you can get this, y'all. No other way to get this besides being in Christ. Come on, tell your neighbor again, being in Christ. And all the messages that we preach and teach and all that we're going to receive and all that we're going to do is simply because we're in Christ, and we never want to get out of Christ for any shape, form, or fashion. We don't want to lean to our own understanding, our own intellect, our own findings about ourselves. We always want to be sure that we are in Christ. Come on, say it again. I'm in Christ. Hallelujah. That means something to the, not only to you, but to the ears of the enemy, the devil. Ain't but one enemy, just the devil. People are not your enemies. Amen? Amen. 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 I said people are not your enemy. The devil is your enemy. And so when you say Christ, he trembles. Say Christ, he just, like that little, animated thing about the Lion King, Mufasa. The devil trembles just the same way when you say Jesus Christ. Yes, yes. You just say Jesus Christ, old man. You remember, he remembered that he went down to toe hell slap up. Come on, everybody, when he resurrected from the dead. Hallelujah. The devil remembered that. Hallelujah. And every time you say Jesus Christ, he remembered that he's defeated. Come on, everybody. Hallelujah. Make him tremble, Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Amen. He tried to make you tremble and trip you up and make you say stuff crazy as a roll. Come on, everybody. He never stopped. Isn't that right? He never stopped saying Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. Even the world around you don't want you to say that. You can pray in every name, but don't just pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. Just don't talk about the name of Jesus. You can do all kind of stuff and this and that. You can see you this. You can say nobody had no problem. But soon you add Jesus Christ to it, oh, you got problems. Come on, everybody. You can look all kind of ways and do this and do that. Just don't say the name of Jesus. Just don't say Jesus Christ. Don't say he's God. Don't recognize he's God. On and on and on. You can recognize he's all. You can recognize he's a prophet. He's a brother. He's a whatever. He is that. But don't say he's God. Only God can change lives. Our prophet can't do it. Our teacher can't do it. Only God can do it. Isn't that right? Isn't that right? I say, isn't that right? And that's where it's at. See, when you know, people share all kinds of stuff, you know, and their lives remain the same. They're all goofy, messed up, shaken up. Come on, everybody. Why? Because they're all about something else besides Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. He's the only one that keep it balanced. Hallelujah. 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 Amen. I didn't mean to get on that, but yes, I did. Hallelujah. And but to this morning, we will continue to speak about something that the Lord has been speaking to us about for weeks now, and we're continuing in that vein. And the Lord is speaking to us to continue in that vein. And this morning, it's about a subject, again, that we're familiar with. And I guess if we continue to hear, because it bears repeating, that we hear this message over and over again. Because I really believe that God has done something special among us in this hour. And again, that we are just really finding the lead of the Spirit in our teachings and what we say and what we're doing. And the Lord knows what is going on and what's coming down the pike, if you will. And he knows everything before everything even started happening. Hallelujah. Yes, isn't that right? And so it's so good to be in Christ. Hallelujah. Yes, hallelujah. He's boss. He's king. He's Lord. He knows everything. Isn't that right? And so we just relax. Hallelujah. And just recline and say, I'm in Christ. Hallelujah. And because you're in Christ, the Spirit of God does something very special on the inside of each every one of us who recognize Christ. Hallelujah. You see, because then the Holy Ghost show up. You know what I'm saying? Without the Holy Ghost showing up, you're going to use your own intellect. You're going to use your own wisdom, your own strength, your own experiences, and on and on and on. You know, it's just going to be you. But so you say Jesus Christ, then the Spirit of God shows up. Why? He always show up when you begin to exalt Jesus. You begin to glorify Jesus. People don't glorify Jesus, the Holy Ghost don't show up. And the Bible says, grieve not the Holy Ghost. And so people grieve the Holy Ghost, come on everybody, when they don't talk about Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 And so I want you to continue to be encouraged and just keep on saying the name of Jesus, the name of Jesus, the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Make the devil scream and scream. Hallelujah. Amen. And so I don't know about you. We need the Holy Ghost to reveal things to us. We cannot know it outside the Holy Ghost. Amen. You can get yourself all, you know, you could be so smart and so intelligent because God gave those intelligence. Hallelujah. Amen. But you remember your intellect is connected to the tree of knowledge of good and evil. And your knowledge of good and evil says, I don't need God. Amen. You don't need God to figure things out. I can figure it out myself. I can see this. I can read that. But how many of you know we need the Holy Ghost to follow God? Amen. In all arenas. Hallelujah. So this morning we were talking about financial freedom. Say financial freedom. Now, when you talk about financial freedom in Christ Jesus, you make the devil mad. The reason why? Because your old mind, your old mindset, your old intellect gets involved when you start talking about money. Just say, that's another thing in the church. Don't never say money in the church. It just sends people into orbit. They got all kind of thoughts, their old thoughts. Come on, everybody. They remember the old pastor who wrote. He wrote in the Cadillac, and everybody else had old broken down cars. Y'all remember that a long time ago? He rides in the big old Cadillac. Everybody bad to get along, can't pay the dues, and can't pay. Hallelujah. Come on, everybody. And so your mind reflected that, man. You know, oh, that's right. Come on, everybody. And they don't let nobody talk about giving money away and talking about the preacher getting this kind of money, this and that. Oh man, they just go ballistic. Why? Because the devil began to use their intellect. Come on, everybody. Amen. How many of you know that the finances of the world is really going to be in line with God because of us? Outside of us, the financial world is corrupt. Oh, that's kind of low there. I said the financial world outside of us is corrupt. And so the devil can keep us from talking about it. You know what? His corruption could continue to go on. Hallelujah. Amen. And so you got all kinds of thoughts about this, thoughts about that, because they're not in Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When you're in Christ, people can say all kinds of stuff, but you know what? Because I'm in Christ, I see this. God all by himself is the one who's continued to work in us by the Spirit. So we can hear what folks saying and say, oh, that's not God. Hallelujah. By the Spirit, not because somebody said something, but the Spirit of God began to reveal it to us. And so we're just going to relax and allow the Spirit of God, you know, to take lead, hallelujah, to continue to be boss in our spirit, hallelujah. Hallelujah. So just relax and incline and let the Spirit of God minister to you. And he is the one that does all the ministry. He's the one that reveals things to us. Outside of him revealing to us, we just got it by our own intuitions. Hallelujah. 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 There are different types of terminology about this, terminology about that. And those terminologies are, you know, are really interpretations, our interpretation about stuff. And so we all have, many times, we all have different interpretation about this. But how many of you know there's but one revelation? Many interpretations, but one revelation. Hallelujah. Amen. And so God wants to walk in the revelation, not in interpretation. Yes. Come on, everybody. And so I want to encourage you, you know, allow the revelation to come to you about finances, about, you know, what God wanted to write, because God is letting us see that again, over and over again, that the financial world is corrupt. And they got to fall. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. And so God wants you, all through the scripture, you know, God wants people, the corrupt folks, to come to you. Hallelujah. God wants you to see, yes, indeed, the God of this world, he's over the devil. He's over this stuff, you know, that's on the earth. He's the prince of the air. Hallelujah. But we have the authority on the earth to bring the power that's above the prince of the air. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, folks don't know what to do outside of us. If you stop praying and stop seeking God and stop lifting your hand to him and loving on the Lord Jesus and falling in love with him and staying in fellowship with the Lord Jesus Christ, the world will get corrupt and corrupt and corrupt. Come on, everybody. It's going to get worse and worse and worse and worse. Hallelujah. This morning we're talking about, again, financial freedom. I have the faith that I need to walk in financial freedom. So I have the faith to walk in financial freedom. Say it again, I have the faith to walk in financial freedom. Now, you said a mouthful, you said I have the faith to walk in financial freedom. Why? Because it takes the faith that God has given you to say that God is the creator of everything and that Jesus is Lord. It's only by faith. It's not by any other way but by faith. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You can't come up any other kind of way. You can't get in any other kind of way. It got to be by faith. Hallelujah. I don't care. You can cry about it and all that. You can get sentimental about it, the on and the whole nine yards. You can do all kinds of stuff. But if you're not walking in faith, only thing that pleases God is what? Is faith. Hallelujah. And thank God, for the Lord gave us what we need to trust him and believe in him and rely on him. He gave it to us. What is called? Faith. And every time you say faith, that means that, you know, it's connected to what Jesus has already done. Amen. So faith is not connected to anything but what Jesus has already done. Yes, sir. Come on, get amen on that. Amen. Say it again. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And say, I so be it. I believe that everything that Jesus has already done, God gave me faith to believe that. Amen. Why? Because faith want to do what God has already done into your now.
Right.
Isn't that right?
Yes.
So you're only walking in the now, what God has already done. You're not walking in nothing else besides what God has already done by faith. Now, if you're not walking in by faith, then you're walking in something else. Hallelujah. And you may be something else. You may not be no Christian. You may be something else. You know? Come on, everybody. And people, you're not walking in faith. You're something else. You ain't no Christian. Come on, everybody. Christians walk by faith. Of course, again, you go by terminology about Christian and all that kind of stuff. We know we're talking about Christian in its real, in its purest form, as followers of Jesus Christ. People don't like that. Well, you know, the Christian was this, and it only was called that name, and it's just all kind of old foolishness that you want to identify with Christ. That's what that's all about. Amen. Amen. Yes, there are some negativity about this, some negative connotation about all kinds of stuff. All through the scripture, they had negative connotation about God. Isn't that right? So don't be surprised because people have negative connotation about stuff. Hallelujah. But the real is real. How many of you know you cannot know the counterfeit without knowing the real? So Jesus is the real deal. Isn't that right? Hallelujah. It's like Coca-Cola. It's a real thing. Everything that's a challenger. Remember that? Pepsi's a challenger. Everything's a... Jesus is the real deal. Hallelujah. And everything is a what? A challenger. Isn't that right? So people challenge your faith. So we walk in fellowship with God and is satisfied because our fellowship with God calls each and every one of us as believers to be what? Satisfied. Say, I'm satisfied. Tell your name, I'm satisfied. Tell me, I'm satisfied. The Bible said, you know, again, that those who hunger and thirst after righteousness, they shall be what? Filled. Hallelujah. You know, when God fear you, you filled. Hallelujah. Yeah. Isn't that right? So I want to encourage you, financial freedom starts off by, again, being in fellowship with the Lord Jesus Christ. You cannot really, precious loved ones, get the cart before the horse. That means that don't get over into, you know, I want to be free financially. I want all this stuff financially. I want this and all. It'll get you to a place that you leave fellowship with God. Amen. And you start concentrating on stuff and getting stuff. And then we get trapped by it. Hallelujah. And we don't mean to be, you know, to get over into that and, you know, in the deep end about stuff. But it does lead to the deep end about stuff because we forgot the priority of putting things first, and that is what? Having fellowship with the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And so I want you to be so encouraged this morning that God tremendously is speaking to us about first standing in fellowship with God. And when you do that, do you know what? All out of that, you begin to see stuff you have never seen before. And I never forget, you know, I grew up in a town, you know, that really there's a religion came to town, and you know, everybody got on board. Many people got on board, especially young people, and it was called Islam. You know, when the Muslims came around and, you know, talking this, you know, these historical facts about this and saying names that we couldn't pronunciate, you know what I'm talking about? We barely could speak English at that time. These kind of talk these, you know, Arabic names. Remember, y'all, a long time ago, so everybody got, you know, why? Because they start massaging your intellect. And massaging your intellect, you say, ooh, oh, yeah, oh, really? Come on, everybody. Where they at today in our communities? Come on, everybody. But at the same time, remember now, religion is a bad booger. Amen. And religion, man, I tell you, it will trap you. It will kill you. It will destroy you. I never forget, you know, they had preachers bringing guns to church. Why? Because religion will kill you. How you going to bring a gun to church to shoot your brother? Come on, everybody. You know what I'm talking about? Religion will kill you. Why? How we know that? Because it killed Jesus. Come on, everybody. Religious Jews. Oh, y'all, hallelujah. Isn't that right? Isn't that right? And so what I'm saying to you, precious loved one, don't, you know, have fellowship with the Lord. Get involved with the real, having fellowship with the Lord. When you have fellowship with him, it's going to be all right. No matter what all folks say, man, God is going to speak to you by the Spirit. God ain't in just one person. He in all of us who are believers. Isn't that right? So it's not about what one person said or what that person said, what Dr. Smellfunger said, or Dr. Ood. No, God is in all of us because we have fellowship with him. God want to hallelujah. Hallelujah. And all what they're doing is reveal what God has already said to us. Amen. You know, when you get you go to the doctor, you may get an opinion from the doctor about this, but you say, I'd like to get a second opinion. Why? Because, you know, you don't agree with that. How you want to make sure, is that right? Isn't that right? So when it comes to things of God, well, what you call him say this and what you call him say that, and you go all ballistic about because somebody, hello? You need to say, let me get a second opinion on that. Hallelujah. But we don't. We just take that and, you know, and swallow that, and, you know, and that's just it. And we start calling folks' name, and our mouth get on this, and our mouth get on that. And next thing you know, the devil got our mouths involved. And once our mouth get involved, that's it. He takes it and runs with it through our mouth. It can't happen unless we say it. If we don't say it, it don't happen. That's why the devil got to get in our mouth to make us say stuff to make it happen, to fortify. Yes. Get you talking about people and talking about the brothers and sisters in the body of Christ. Why? The devil wants to get your mouth on it, because if you get your mouth on it, he's going to seal it. He don't want you to say, the Bible say, you know, let your love overcome faults. Hallelujah. Amen. How many of you know we all got faults? But the Bible said love will overcome that. Why? Because God don't want our mouths to be speaking against each other. God wants us to love each other. Amen. Love is the only thing that's powerful than hating and jealousy and all that, lust and all. Love is more powerful, isn't that right? But the enemy wants to get over to that stuff to keep us trapped. But you know, I thank God that we can stay in, you know, this financial freedom beginning with Christ. And that's before we even think about stuff, before we think about financial struggles and what we in and how we messed up and how we did this, how we made mistakes and all that. No, it's all about being in him. Then God is going to cause all that to work out. Hallelujah. The Bible said God will cause all things, what, to work together for good for them who do what? Huh? See what I'm talking about? So you're not in fellowship with him and love him. Those things ain't gonna work out together for you. You quote all you want, but you ain't in love with God. You're in love with stuff. Come on, everybody, I can get this, and I can get free. I can stay free. I can, you know, get what I want to get and be all right. And then, no, it ain't about it. It's about I love him. I love him. I love him. I love. Come on, everybody say, I love him. I love him. Woo, I love him. I love him. I'm just so excited about him. Hallelujah. Why? When you do that, then God gonna cause all things. All things. All things. That's why he said, what? Seek first the kingdom. The kingdom is what? Righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. Righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. I'm seeking that first. Righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. That's priority. That's first on the list. Everything else follows after that. Hallelujah. I ain't got time for nothing else. If I seek it in the Bible, so then God said, I'm going to add all that. I'm going to add that to you. You want that? I'm going to add that to you. I'm going to add all that stuff that you want. Hallelujah. But I want you to do what? Seek first. Hallelujah. Seek first what? The kingdom, not stuff. Isn't that right? The kingdom. What's the kingdom is? Righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Ghost. Now look that up. Hallelujah. All your healing, all your deliverance comes after you do what? Seek first the kingdom. Seek first the kingdom. Guys, I'm going to add healing to you. I'm going to add that. Come on, everybody. Oh, hallelujah. The world doesn't understand where you get your spiritual wealth from. So pass the test. Now, let me say it again. The world doesn't understand where you get your spiritual wealth from. Pass the test. You let folks know, you know, you got to let the folks know how to kind of eat the cabbage. They really don't know. I mean, they're doing their best to do this and do that. And thank God, you know, there are some financial investments that we do. We're going to talk about that too and so forth. But at the same time, it's all about having the wisdom of God concerning it. Not the world's wisdom. The world's wisdom is based on experiences about stuff and how they do stuff among each other. Hallelujah. But God has a wisdom how to do stuff that supersedes the world's wisdom. Amen. So, precious loved one, we're going to stand on the wisdom of God. And the Bible says how we get the wisdom of God, we got to dig deep into God. I'm after you, Lord. I'm solely after you. Why? Because wisdom is God. God is wisdom. Hallelujah. The Bible said, in Christ, the treasures are in him. Wisdom is in him. Hallelujah. So faith laid hold of God's word and experienced the power of God. Let me say it again. Faith lays hold of God's word and experienced the power of God. So when you begin to live this life of faith, you're first after him. You're in love with him. And then the word that comes from God. And the Bible said, man don't live by what? By bread alone. But by what? Why do you say bread? Because bread is the very substance that we, you know, that keep us alive. And come on, everybody. They give us strength to do this and so forth. But what about the Bible says the joy of the Lord is ours? That's right. Hallelujah. 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 That's why they told the disciples, I got bread you not know of. Hallelujah. Come on, everybody. We're the same people. We live by faith. We got a bread that the world don't know nothing about. Hallelujah. What's keeping us alive? Hallelujah. What, you know, what brings substance to them and keep them this and that? But we got something that's holding us together. The one who's hold everything together. The one who holds everything together is holding us together. Hallelujah. So let them go on with their thoughts about this and their thoughts about that, and let us have these thoughts that will counteract with their thoughts. Why not? The woman with the issue of blood laid aside all arguments and excuses and came by faith to Jesus. She came by what? Faith to who? To Jesus. You can't come in your intellect. Hallelujah. Amen. When something happened to you, the first thing you go to is some professional. Somebody that you value. Come on, everybody. Isn't that right? Isn't that right? Somebody that you honor, somebody you esteem, you go to them. First, something happens, you go right, you call right them. You call them. You call some banking institution, come on, everybody, some doctor, some lawyer. How you get some type of legal scrap or whatever, you call some lawyer. And all these lawyers on TV, you know, they're flashing all these infomercials. And next thing you call one of them, oh, you got to get one, you got to get him, you got to get, cause, you know. Hello? And so the thing about that, you know, that we highly esteem who? Jesus. Come on, everybody. The first person we should go to is who?
Jesus.
Now, he the one that's going to get the man, whoever, the doctor, all the professional, what? Wisdom beyond their years of experience. The one we put out, hallelujah. Amen. I'm not saying nothing wrong with it. There's nothing wrong with going with them, but it is wrong to go to them first. Come on, tell your neighbors, there is something wrong with going with them first. Because first you should do what? Seek the kingdom. Come on, everybody. That's first. Amen. Don't go to that doctor and open your mouth. Ah. Oh, yeah. The first thing they say, open your mouth. Ah. You're wide open. Just say, I don't know what he made. Just throw something in your mouth. You say, ah. Isn't that right? And when you say, ah, they tell you, oh, you got this. And next thing you know, I got what? Isn't that right? You don't have no second appeal, nothing. You go home and tell everybody, I got this. You got no big old long name behind. And you trying to pronounce that name. Come on, everybody. You can barely speak English. You try to pronounce that name, that long title name. Tell everybody about how got to hold on that long to check that old day. And they say, what? Yeah, you articulate to everybody else. I mean, what is that again? You know, they tell you, go on and tell, yeah, try this right here. Tell me, I got this right here. It's a very rare form of this. Hello? Hello? But seek first. Okay, thank you, sir. Thank you for the report. Let me go home. The report, I believe, is God's report. Come on, everybody. So therefore, I got to get a word from God. I got to get a word from God. Because revelation, I stand on revelation knowledge. Hallelujah. I build on revelation knowledge. And all that's going to be in my mouth, will be what? Filled with revelation knowledge. If my mouth is filled with revelation knowledge, my heart is filled with revelation knowledge. Because the Bible says, out of my mouth should what? Speak the abundance of my heart. And so the abundance of my heart is revelation knowledge about God, that he is the healer. And God would give, I'll never forget, you know, the doctor told me that I had a bulging disc in my back, in my neck, and he said the only thing corrected is surgery. I said, hold on, I got to go talk to Deidre, hallelujah. My wife said, who is that? I said, my wife, I'm going to talk to her about it. And so I came home and told her, I said, he said this, he's got an MRI. They gave me all kind of shots, y'all, cortisone shots all in my arm and stuff. The pain was excruciating. You know, then you know, you can handle pain, but when it start to bother your rest, you can't sleep. You come on, everybody. You can't sleep. You got, oh, something got to happen. Hallelujah. Isn't that right? And something got to happen. Something got to happen real fast. Hallelujah. And so, I came home and told Deidre about it, and she looked at me and so forth. And I said, we'll be praying about it. He said, gonna do this and that, and gave me all kind of contraptions and so forth, you know. And I just said, okay, Lord, hallelujah. I never forget, I was telling somebody the other day, that I went in my prayer time, my prayer room, and what I do, and I said, let's just start dancing before the Lord, like I normally do, just dance before him. And a revelation came to me that said that Jesus is the healer. Well, I knew God was a healer. Come on, everybody. But he said, Jesus is the healer. And man, that spoke so loud to me. And when they say he is the healer, then all of a sudden God healed me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I've been, I don't know about what, long time ago. I mean, I couldn't even, you know, look, when I can't talk, that means something wrong. Hallelujah. I had to go counseling me with people. They just talking. I was out of it, y'all. I just say very living words. I said, okay, all right, y'all, bye. They kind of looked at me, you know, very few words. I was in pain. Come on, everybody. I done went on the vacation. Everybody was having a great time and so forth. I looked at them like them, and they're laughing and talking. I was in pain. They was enjoying themselves. I was on vacation with, but I was in pain. But God, hallelujah. Glory, he is the healer. Come on, everybody. And so, but you know what? God gave you a revelation to stand on and put it in your mouth. And then what are you going to do to all, each and every one of us? Whatever we go through, God will give us a revelation on it that we can stand on it. Not just because the word said it, but God will give you, you know, something super on that word that you can stand on. Hallelujah. That's what makes us so, yeah, everybody can quote the word, but they don't get the results. I don't want to get the results of those who receive what revelation on that word. And if you got full of the Holy Ghost, and if you don't have Jesus, you can't be full of the Holy Ghost. So you don't even have a revelation on the word. All you just have a knowledge of the word. Come on, everybody. Hallelujah. And the knowledge is not going to do it. It's going to take what? Revelation for you to stand on. Hallelujah. The word says you can walk on water. You ain't going to walk on water. I bet you ain't going to try it. Go out there to Mississippi and try to walk on the cup. Hallelujah. Hello? But if God gave you revelation, come on, everybody. You can walk right on that. You're walking away. You're walking on revelation across that river. Hallelujah. Had a priest say, man, yeah, you can walk on water. And he went on and told everybody, I'm going to walk on water. I'm going to walk until the whole congregation came outside. We're going to walk on water today. And the whole congregation went down there and said, I'm going to walk on water. And he walked, you know, he tried to walk, everybody looking. The pastor going to walk on water. It's a phenomenon, they say, just like the Bible said. And he walked in and went out there, everybody looking, and he sank. Yeah. And they went out to go get the pastor. He said, I'm getting ready to walk on water. He sank again. And, you know, he got to this side, and, you know, the Lord told him, said, you know, he's going to go to the other side on the water. And the Lord already told him, said, you know what? He said, that's a bridge right there. Come on, everybody. Just go over the bridge. Hallelujah. Amen. What they did, the thing about what's going on is that you are tempting God. God is too wise for that. Hallelujah. Amen. Come on, everybody. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. That you don't have revelation. You just get into all kind of foolishness. Now, his whole congregation, you think his whole congregation is going to trust him from now? He's just saying stuff out the side of his neck. That's what everybody's going to say. You know, they just sitting there, and they sit there for years, you know, and hallelujah. But God wants to bring us out of a place that we will operate from a premise that will honor God. Say, thank God for the Holy Ghost. Because he revealed the word to us. The Bible says it was hidden, you know, about stuff. And the Old Testament was hidden. That stuff was hidden. It was hidden back there. But the Holy Ghost is revealed to us in the now. Oh, hallelujah. And people say, well, I got this. I know this. And I know that. How do you know that if you don't have the Holy Ghost operating? And you can't have the Holy Ghost operating without what? Having Christ. If you don't exalt Christ, the Holy Ghost is nowhere around. Uh-huh. So through faith in Christ, by the power of the Holy Ghost, we are connected, directed to the kingdom of God, which is God ruling and reigning from the inside of our spirit. Now, I want to encourage you about this. The Bible, remember the scripture said, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, thy kingdom come. How many know the kingdom has already come? Where the kingdom of God is? It's in us. In each, isn't that right? I said, the kingdom of God has already come. I said, the kingdom of God has already come. And where it's come? In us. So therefore, the Lord said, I want you to look. Let the kingdom rule in all of your affairs. Let the kingdom of God rule in all your affairs. And that means let the word of God, let the revelation from about the kingdom of God have rule and reign in your financial affair, your business affair, your marital affair, your healing affair. Come on, everybody. In every affair, let the kingdom of God what? Rule and reign. So you ought to say that every morning, Lord, let the kingdom, I let the kingdom that's in me rule and reign in all of my affairs. So therefore, I got the wisdom of God concerning all those affairs. Therefore, I'm allowing what the Spirit of God to bring revelation to me about all the affairs that are concerning me. Hallelujah. You're going through something in your marriage. You're going through something in this and that. You're struggling about that. Man, get a revelation from God about it. Amen. Where's it going to come from? From the inside of you? Oh, hallelujah. Yeah. To access the kingdom, you must what? Change the core of your thinking. The Lord Jesus, you're going to get serious now. The Lord Jesus Christ began his Galilean ministry with repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. Remember, repent is what? A decision that results in a change of mind, which in turn leads to a change of purpose and action. So the thing about it is you cannot repent if you're not going to do different. Yep. Yeah. Amen. If you would continue your same old way, your same old thinking, then you know what? You just repent, you know, just saying the word. You talk out the side of your neck. When you say I repent, that means that I'm going to change my action and my purpose. Hallelujah. I made a decision. I'm going to change. And that's what the Lord is saying right now. He needs all of us. Remember, he started the Galilean ministry by telling everybody, repent first. Why? Because, you know, all of us, y'all, we got all kind of jacked up thinking. Yeah. Amen. Concerning what we're talking about finances today. We got jacked up thinking about financial world, about finance, how to do finance. We don't know nothing really about finance according to our parents. Hello? Come on, everybody. They ain't teach us stuff, hallelujah, about no finance. Amen. It talks about shortage. They talk about, you know, that money don't grow on trees. Isn't that right? Now, some of y'all got some good family members that, you know, they taught you about that, but I didn't, hallelujah. They was good, but sometimes they just don't shout me down, hallelujah. But I just want to encourage you about this, you know, this very thought that you got to have a change of mind. Even though you may have been taught some things, but you know about in Christ, it's a whole different ball game. And God wants you to say, I want you to think separate from what you are trained in. Why? To get it the way I want to give it to you. Thank God for that. Remember, our old thinking and routine behavior were handed down in our family for generations. The iniquities of the father has been passed down to us as children. Behaviors and thoughts inherited are anger, inferiority, fear, anxiety, jealousy, and lust. But today we're talking about what will cause us not to experience financial freedom from God. Those who are in financial trouble is because of fear. Someone say fear. So fear is a devil. Fear is a spirit, and it comes from what? The devil. Because the Bible says God has not given us what? The spirit of what? Of fear. So where it comes from? It's the devil. Isn't that right? God has given us a spirit of what? A love, power, and a sound mind. So how in the heaven we can operate on fear and think we can get anything from God? Yeah. Yeah. Not only that, remember now, many of us outside of Christ operate from fear. Mm-hmm. We did. Come on, everybody, people that invest in this and invest in that because they operate from a fear principle. Amen. Amen. And so therefore, the Lord said, I want you to get out of that spirit of fear. I want you to think, and we got that. We inherited it from our parents, that fear. You remember children, you know, they think they can do anything. Yeah. Isn't that right? So we had to learn some stuff that we could, hallelujah. Something you had to learn, you know, that we could, hallelujah. That you had to learn this by this and learn by the experience you can't do this and so forth. But then they brought about a fear. Yeah. And it was an unhealthy fear at that too. Why? Because it kept us from really trusting God and trusting in our own selves and our own understanding. Remember the story recorded in Matthew chapter 24, verse 19 and 28. You know, the three servants are given pounds and two of them invested. And their master commended them. But he scolded the third servant for being too, what, timid, fearful, afraid, and frightened, even to place his pound in a bank where he may have earned some interest. Here is the principle that the Lord is going to speak to us again, that why he is letting us know from this story that God, everything we have has been given to us by God. Come on, say, everything I have has been given to me. By God. Everything I have has been given to me by God. And so God said, I want you to do something. I've given this to you for you can use it. Come on, everybody, that you can gain more. But if you don't use it, you can't come. Hallelujah. So there's stuff that God has given us. There's some wisdom and some talents and all that God has given us. And we're not using it. Hallelujah. How many know if you don't use it, you're what? Isn't that right? If you don't use those muscles, you'll lose. So he's talking about the same thing. He said there's a muscle that you have, but fear will cause you. Remember, fear will stop you from lifting weights. Yeah. Why? Because you say, I'm scared I may hurt myself. If you're scared you may hurt yourself and you don't exercise your muscle, what's going to happen? You're going to lose what you possess. Yep. Isn't that right? You're going to lose what you possess, and you will not gain what you already have. Right. Why? Because you didn't use it. But see, fear keep you from using. Hallelujah. So the devil don't want you to invest your money. He don't want you to use the money that God has given you. Hallelujah. He's got you, well, if I do that, if I give this, if I give a $1 out of 10, I only have 9 left. Come on, isn't that right? Isn't that right? And so all we know is fear associated with it. A lack is associated with, you know, when we start giving out what God's giving. Just same thing with your time and your talent. We're going to see in a few minutes that, you know, because we're timid there, because that came from our forefather, came from our parents, if you will. And, you know, we inherit that. And so then about we got to do what? Repent. Have a change of mind. That's why I say I want you to have a change of mind to get the way God wants you to get this thing. So in that story, you know, you can read that story later. But the business world says it this way: it takes money to what? To make money. Another way of understanding it, a man with big biceps, again, cannot continue to have, you know, the strength that he have if he don't use what God has given him. Isn't that right? And so I want you to see that, that as we continue to do and use what God has given us, then you know what's going to happen? More is going to be given to us. We're going to possess it, and we're going to gain more. That's why he told us that man, what he did, he said, because he feared, he hid the money. Come on, everybody. He hid the money. And so God trying to get some over to us again. And that is all simply saying that I want you to have fear about giving money. When they start talking about money, people, their fear grips them. Isn't that right? He wants you, man, just be what? Cheerful. He wants you to be free-hearted. Why? Because God want to do, he want to get more over to you. He wants you to put, he wants you to keep what you have and give you more. Amen. Hallelujah. It's offer to give something and don't get anything in return. Amen. A wise man won't do that. Nobody do that. Amen. Hallelujah. If you keep on, you know, that's just like putting the money in a pocket with a hole in it. I keep giving you money. It don't do you no good. It just leak right on out. Leak right on out. Come on, the man keep on coming to you and say, can you give me this? Yeah, leak right on out. Can you get this? No. So that pocket, like we talked about last time. Because of this purpose, this process of repentance, we will destroy all, this is very careful, all of our preconceived ideas about money from how our parents managed money. Many times it was in fear. So the process will cause you to meditate on the promises God has made to you as a tither, so that you can tithe in faith, believing that God will keep his end of the covenant. Now, what is all about again? Again, this is special to us because we can read what the Word of God says, but remember, the Scripture is tied into what? Your love for God. Let me say it again. The Scriptures is tied in with your love for God. Without your love for God, then you all of us is going to get what? Interpretation about Scripture. I say, without God's love and the Spirit of God operating, we all gonna have what? An interpretation of the Scripture. Not a revelation. It'll be what? An interpretation of the Scripture. And everybody can what? Have an interpretation. Everybody have an opinion about that. An opinion about. But revelation is no opinion. It is what God says. It lined up from A to Z. Isn't that right? Isn't that right? And so the Bible don't want us to pick and choose out the Word of God. Hey, come on, everybody. We can't pick and choose. Well, I'm not going to do this, but I'm going to do that. That's called a process of elimination. I like this. I don't like that. I'm putting this to my life. Come on. No, you don't pick and choose. Revelation said it from A to Z, from Old Testament to New Testament. It says the same thing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And so the Word of God says, you know what? Well, if you do this, come on, it's still the Word of God. Even if it's in the Old Testament, it's still the Word of God. Isn't that right? But only faith can do what the Word says. And where faith comes from God, hallelujah. So if I do decide I'm to do this, if I do it by faith, come on, everybody, it's hallelujah. Because I'm in love with him. I'm in love with him. How many of you know that God Almighty, and you know who, the Bible said, where were you when I created this? When I made it, how in the hell you can have your own counsel outside of God? And so you're in love with him. God can tell you by his Spirit, yes, yes, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Even though people make error, that's okay. They made an error. Glory to God. But God says that. How you know it's an error? Because the Word of God says this. Hallelujah. And you just keep on living and keep on living. And the reason why people in fear and so forth, why? Because you stop doing what you've been doing unto God and start doing what they say. Hallelujah. And so therefore you walking in fear. Now you walking in fear and doing what they say in fear. You're not doing it in love. Because God is love. You do everything under. We can have what? A relationship with the Lord. How many of you know that God can tell you by his spirit and he wants you to walk in this? Come on, everybody. The Holy Ghost can say, I want you to do this. I want you to do that. And when you do it, you're doing it in love. You're doing it in love. And everybody starts sinning. Why? Because love is the only thing that never fails. Isn't that right? So if you continue to love, it never fails. Hallelujah. So if you stay in love with the Lord, hallelujah, and you tithe in faith, we always say you can't just tithe. You have to tithe in faith. Amen. Because the Bible's the only thing the police got is what? It's not about just tithe. Well, I just tithe. You know, and you know, I don't have to because I just, no, you're right. You don't have it because you just tithe. Bible says, well, tithe in faith. And your tithe in faith is connected to you with your love for God. And your love for God said, Jesus has already done this, so therefore I'm going to give it to you. Hallelujah. Amen. You're not getting something that Jesus has already done for you. Isn't that right? I say, isn't that right? And so when you tithe the Bible, when you tithe, I'm open to what the windows of heaven. Come on, put that on the Malachi 3 and 10. Put that on the word, right? And just, you know, you just do this in faith. Now, this just do, you got to do this in faith now. Now, people just do this because we're out of tradition. People just do this because, you know, that's the right thing to do. That's the thing we all do. We just, you know, we just do this. It's like paying dues. We just pay dues. Come on, everybody. Whatever they say, $5, $10, $15, holler, we just pay dues. So when they start coming to tithe, that's the devil. Oh, yeah, you remember long time, that was a devil. Now, today, you know, we're talking about all kinds of stuff. Now, we're so spiritual smart today and so spiritual in the neck today, we still send it, you know, I don't know, but, you know, I ain't going to do that. Why? Because you're not doing it in faith. I guarantee they cannot tell you if you do it in faith, hello, ain't nothing going to happen. I guarantee they won't tell you that. That'll stop everything right there. You mean to tell me if I stop doing this in faith? But if I do it in faith, God, come on. If I bring all the tithe by faith, if I bring what? All the tithe, that 10 in the storehouse by faith, so that there may be food in my house and what? And test me. Not to say food in here, we're not talking about the real food that, you know, not, we're not talking about the food that you actually eat. We're talking about, the Bible say meat. And King James say what? Meat. That meat mean what? That meat mean that revelation from God. And so when you open up the gear, then therefore the Lord will bring revelation to you in the church. Come on, about meat. Why? Because we don't live by bread alone. But by what? Revelation. So you say that when you tithe, you open the storehouse, so that would be what? Meat. So meat, what? Revelation for you to live on. Oh! And you start getting revelation. But man, God gave me this. God spoke to me when I did it. God said it to me. Why? Because he said, when you open up for revelation knowledge. Come on, y'all. Come on, y'all. You got to get this thing. Stop getting in the natural, in the physical realm. And no, God wants you to come up in the spirit and live in the spirit. Hallelujah. Amen. And said, in my house that test me now in this. Test me in this, says the Lord of hosts. Test me. That's why I'm saying the world don't know how to know nothing about this. They don't know nothing about it, so therefore we're going to pass the test and tithe. Right. Oh, look at it said, right? And said to the Lord of hosts, if I will not open the window. He said, look what it said. That says what? The Lord of hosts. Says the Lord. Ain't talking about no man, no prophet, Isaiah, come on, everybody. The Lord of hosts said this. We're not talking about no ancient prophet or whatever. And thank God for all of them, Bible characters and so forth. All that's good. Hallelujah. But the Lord of hosts said this. If I do that, if I will not open for you the what? The windows of heaven and pour. I don't know about you. Hallelujah. If you got the key to your door and you open your door every time because you got the key to your, come on, everybody. And somebody come along and say, that ain't the key. Are you, oh, y'all get. It's not right to come on and say, that ain't the key. Because it ain't the same color their key is and, you know, all this. They don't have to do that on that key. I've been using the key to open the door. Now, come on, everybody, you open that. How in the hell is somebody going to get to tell you about something that ain't the key? You got it in your hand. It's been opening the door all these years for you, and right now, it don't open the door for you. Well, you know, that ain't the right key. That ain't the right color. You're doing it wrong for the first time. All I want the door open. Boop. You got all kinds of ways to open the door, but guess what? That's your way. Come on, everybody. Why I got to stop doing it your way? Well, you know, I open the door like this and like that. Matter of fact, I open the door like this. Come on, everybody. Good. It's all about the door with being. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I don't know about you. You don't go no certain kind of open your door. You just go open the door. You don't put one foot up like this. You don't be dramatic about it. You know, you do this, you open the door. No, you just go there, open the door. Hallelujah. Everybody got all kinds of that. The thing about it is, it's by faith. And I'm doing it by faith. I might do it. I got the results. Somebody said, if I ain't broke, why fix it? And now you got your results. I'm getting the results. Hallelujah. Amen. I'm getting my results from God. And so you get your results. Okay, be all good. Hallelujah. Amen. I put my trust in God. And so the scripture encouraged. No, he said, look, open the windows of heaven, pour out what? Out for you so great a blessing until there is what? No more room. You mean, Tim, if I'm getting that, if I'm getting what the Bible says right here, you think I'm going to listen to you? The only person that listens to somebody saying they ain't did because they were, they ain't getting it, hallelujah. Come on, isn't that right? If you're just getting the dribbles, hallelujah, the Bible said out of your belly shall flow a stream. No, it didn't. Rivers. And so that's really why people, when they speak in tongues, their tongues in this right here. But you're right, because you just got streams. But if you got rivers, I said, if you got rivers and they're flowing out, you don't care what nobody say. I want you to be so encouraged. The financial world is all about, again, it's connected to what? Our love for Jesus. Fall in love with him and glorify the Lord Jesus Christ. And then the Holy Ghost show up and give us Revelation 9. Then we read the scripture. Wow! We are fascinated by it. Then next thing you know, God has blessed us. Hallelujah. Look, he wants to bless us what? Abundantly, not just some stuff. And the reason why people got all kinds of thoughts about it, because they're just getting a lip blessing. I said a lip blessing. But the scripture say not no lip blessing. God wants to abundantly, hallelujah, bless us. Isn't that right? Like I said, you know, if you just got one, if you got tomato plant, you just got one tomato, you're just going to keep for yourself. Or two tomatoes for your family. Or two, three tomatoes, oh, yeah, just me and my family. But when you got thousands of tomatoes, you ain't kept all, you ain't canned and stewed, hallelujah, and fried and everything. You got to get them things away. Isn't that right? I say, isn't that right? It going to hurt your heart if they rot. Come on, everybody. So you got to what? Give it away. God knows what he's doing. That's why someone give you what? More abundantly. Why? Because I want you to give it to somebody else. That's my way. Because the world don't know anything about it. You blessed because of me. Their job is blessed because of you. The God who you serve, the God who you love, who is Lord over your life, when you show up, the economic places changes. The whole entire environment changes because of you. That job is blessed. It's protected because of you on there. I never forget Brother Larry telling me at the plant that, you know, a disaster took place. He said if he didn't went to work that day, he would have blew up when that unit blew up. Come on, everybody. What I'm saying is, God, when God is with you, you're the one, hallelujah. Come on, everybody. I never forget, man, the lady told me, said, you can't handle lunch at this place. I used to bring my lunch, y'all, to this establishment. I just get a cold drink. And the people say, you know, you can't have lunch here anymore. I said, I used to eat with a friend there. They said, no more, because you didn't buy, they're selling this particular stuff. I said, I brought my lunch. I'm just talking to this person here and so forth. And me said, that's your last time coming. I said, okay. And I did that. I said, all right. And next thing you know, what came in me said, it's going to close down. Come on, y'all. A week or two later, it was closed down. Come on, everybody. You understand who we are in Christ. Hallelujah. We're not just some bump on the log or just can't alone ourselves. Or we just la-la-la people. No, we ain't. God is with us. We're in Christ. Hallelujah. We bad to debone. Hallelujah. By what? By being in Christ Jesus. Come on, say, by being in Christ Jesus. We bad to debone. Do you understand who I am? Hallelujah. Stuff will close down if they disrespect you. Hallelujah. 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 folk will do all this and all that because, you know what, they don't think, you know, you this, but, you know, God going to back you up. I said, God will fight your battles. Hallelujah. God will go to fight for you. You fall in love with God, will go to fight for you. Again, this is all by God's grace and God's mercy, too. Amen, because we don't always get it right. Hallelujah. We don't always cross every T and dot every I. Well, God don't care anyway about that anyway. Because grace come in. If we cross every T and dot every I, then, you know, we think we did something. It's us. I did all this. I did this. I did that. And I still ain't got nothing. Come, you still need grace. Come on, everybody say, I still need grace. And that grace is just saying, you know what, well, you know, you may not have crossed the T that day. You may have said something you forgot about. You didn't remember. But God said, hey, because of grace, I'm doing it for you anyway. Hallelujah. Thank God for that. If you can't remember everything you did, hallelujah, and how you did, isn't that right? Isn't that right? So if you did, you're a bad person, hallelujah. What I mean by that, you can't do it all every day, 365. And so thank God for grace that we can, hallelujah, God can bless us beyond measure. Isn't that right? So the Lord wants us to realize that God want to take care of you. He want to take care of you, and he want to bless you with abundantly. So the process of repentance, again, will cause us to stimulate the activities of the Holy Spirit to destroy Satan's strategy to make it hard to have life and have it more abundantly. The devil has a strategy, y'all, to how to keep us from living life and having it more abundantly. That is a strategy. Well, listen to me very carefully. A lot of things that is happening to us is we are carrying out the devil's strategy. Hallelujah. Why? Because the Bible says the things that we see now, they're only what? Temporary. And because our faith in God, we can change it. It's only temporary because we have our faith in God. Without our faith in God, that thing say what? Permanent. It will be as it is. Hallelujah. So you know what? This happened to you. Guess what? Your faith in God going to change it. Why? Because he's a God of restoration. The Bible says God will take what the canker worm, the pomer worm has eaten up and do what? And restore back to you. Amen. The devil did this and he did that. Yeah, he stole this out of your life. He eaten this up out of your life. But we serve the God who restores. And all I got to do is get a revelation from God about he restores. If I get a revelation about God who restores, who cares he ate that up? It's going to change. Who cares he stole it? I'm going to get more. The reason why I'm caring about it is because I have a revelation that God is a God of abundance. Hallelujah. He stole one thing from you. God, so I'm going to give you 10 more of these. And guess what? If you catch that joker stealing from God, I'm going to make him pay you what? Seven. So all I got to do is that the devil stole this, God. He said, okay, because you know it's the devil who stole this, I'm going to cause him to give you to what? Seven. Amen. Come on, say the devil. I mean, the people, not your enemy. It's the devil. So let the people know that stealing is of the devil. The Bible says, steal no more. Hallelujah. You used to steal. Don't steal no more. Amen. You used to lie. Don't lie to each other. All right, I'm going to hold that up for a thought. Yeah, I'm about to say something. Hallelujah. But I want you to be encouraged that our presence, in the community does not go unnoticed. I say our presence in the community does not go unnoticed. We affect economic growth, government, and the city's environment. Everywhere we go, yeah, we bring an effect. We bring an impact. Each and every one of us, no matter where we are, we bring about an impact. People just say, man, where do you get that from? Where that thought come from? How did that happen? And, but, you know, stuff just coming to us. This just coming together. Why? Because of you. Because of you. And that means that all of that is coming out of, which I always tell everybody about the ministry here. The ministry here is successful, precious loved ones, because everything we do and everything we're a part of, it comes out of prayer. That's why we call Saturday what powerhouse prayer. Everything flows through that. And the enemy will fight them tooth and nail about prayer, about this and about that, and personality clicks and all that, and all kind of hiccups, all kind of stuff to keep people from praying, hallelujah. And then look what, and put your mouth on it. The devil use your mouth against your precious brothers and sisters. I don't know about you, but I never talk about my ugly toe. I don't talk about that ugly, it's ugly toe, but I don't talk about it. Amen. Come on. I don't go around and say, I got an ugly toe. My ugly toe. Ugly. I got an ugly toe. Ugly. Come on, everybody. Yeah, it's ugly. But what I'm saying is that we do it with the body of Christ. We just talk about each other. Come on, everybody. We're trying to live by faith, and you know, being used of the Lord to battle. You know, I'm telling you, to battle in the spirit. You know, people are glad that they go to heaven because they, you know, they've been under the burden, under the weight of fighting in the spirit. For you, people fighting, they're fighting the enemy for you. Stuff is coming in them from the devil all kind of ways. Amen. They gotta go to war against that joker. They gotta bind them up in the name of Jesus. They gotta rise up out of their sleep and bind them in Jesus. They lose sleep. Because God revealed things, and they gotta go to war for you. They go to war for you, and you up there trying to talk. How dare you put your mouth on them? But the enemy wanna use, come on, everybody. That's the same thing about everything. They want you to put your mouth on it, and they trying to pray for you and speak to God. You don't know what they do in the night season. Amen. I got the strength of God because people been praying for me. Because I need it. I know you understand, man. I'm all right. People been praying for me. Hallelujah. People love me and bless my glory to God. I'm able to do what I'm doing. Hallelujah. Why? Because people are praying. When I'm sending you, I'm sending you, precious loved one, people are praying for you in this church. You getting blessings upon blessings, and things are happening for you because of people praying. Now, the only people not getting blessed and really getting the things of God because they're speaking against. I said, because they're speaking against. And yet they got little dribbles. Come on, everybody. They got little dribbles coming by. They got little dribbles, little droplings coming to them. Come on, everybody. They got little dribblings over here, little droplings over there, a little this and a little there over there. But God said, I want to give you what? Blessings abundantly. I want to give you rivers of blessings. I want to give you more than enough. But you know, you can't get dribblings away. They're just enough for you. I said, just enough for you. But God, that ain't God the way God wants. He said, I want you to repent, have a different mindset that it's all about blessing somebody else. God said, I want to have you so much. You got to bless somebody else. Hallelujah. Amen. Ain't nobody going to bless you with nothing if they ain't got enough for themselves. Amen. And then, you know, it depends on what they give you too. Some people give you, 10 cents. You know what that means? Hallelujah. Come on, everybody. That tell you where they at. Amen. They give you 10 cents, but where they at? Why are you going to give me 10 cents? Then that means you must got a hallelujah. Isn't that right? Yeah. I said, isn't that right? Yeah. You go to your neighbor, you're not going to just give them, I'm going to bring only one cucumber for you. I dare you go to your neighbor just with one cucumber. Amen. You go there with a basket load. Isn't that right? Isn't that right? Well, like you know, Miss Sylvia laughing over there right now. When she come to church, man, she don't just bring one little slice of cake. She bring individual wrapped, hallelujah, slices of cake for all of, everybody around here know that she makes some good cake. Why? Because she brings slices. Hallelujah. Why? It's abundance. She make a whole big, she'll just make one little piece of cake, hallelujah. Either her husband, he want to leave some home, But at the same time, won't you be so encouraged that God wants us to be what? Abundantly. Why? Because he wants to walk in financial freedom. We can walk in financial freedom. Well, a change of mind about stuff. And God has blessed you with stuff. And God has blessed us with, look at them, listen to me very carefully. But God wants you not only to be blessed financially, but he wants you to let the world know and all everybody know that God is blessing us. And how you know that God is blessing? It's on you. The abundance is on you. Hallelujah. Well, you know, God is blessing us. You really don't have anything to give. Something ain't right with that. And not only that, God is blessing me, and you don't give in abundance, something ain't right with that either. Hello? 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 And the one God is blessing abundantly doing stuff, come on, everybody. And guess what? The God is blessing them abundantly, and you know, and you don't have, that's the reason why you're jumping on board with them. Hello? And that's wrong, too. Why that's wrong? Because the Bible says, all that you have and all that you're going to get, I want you to get it from me. Amen. I want you to get it from somebody else and then give it to me. I want you to get it from, you know, can I borrow this from you? Okay. And when I borrow from you, I'm going to go get somebody else something that I borrow from you. Come on. Hello? Yes, then who bless you? That person over there, not you. Yes, sir. Amen. Instead of God blessing you, and because God bless you, you're going to bless some. Hallelujah. Who bless you, God? Isn't that right? I say, isn't that right? People who are in our circle of influence recognize that we have tapped into a spiritual reality that is not known to them by their way of life or lifestyle. We have the power of God. And that scripture I want you to look at is Luke chapter 17, verse 21, the Amplified version. I want you to put that on board for us. And we have the power of God operating in us, through us. That is the kingdom, listen to everybody, the kingdom of God that lives and rules in us. They see that you have joy when others are sad. And you have peace, and you know, when others are in chaos and trouble or storm. Nothing seems to move you from your position of peace. It seems to them that you are living on a high plane of life. They see that you are not just hanging on. You're living above all. Precious love, well, that's what God wants us to be. Why? Because look at the scripture says in Luke 17, 21, Amplified. Let us read. Stand and read. Let's go. Come on, everybody. Look at it. When we read it again, it says, what's it? Know what people say. Look, here it is, or there it is. For what? The kingdom of God is among you because of what? My presence. Now put that in, King James Version. King James 17:21. Come on, let's read it. All right. Neither shall they say, lo here or lo there. For behold, the kingdom of God is what? Where is it? Why? So the Bible says everything, what's going on with you, everything about you is coming from within. It's coming from within. And God is in you. Hallelujah. Come on, y'all. It's attached to what? Kingdom. Now, put one more scripture up there, Romans 5:17. Look what it says, Romans 5:17. Romans 5, look what it says here. Let's read, y'all. For if by one man's offense death reigned by one, much more they which receive abundance of grace and of the gift of righteousness shall reign in life by one Jesus Christ. Okay. Now I want you to read that, put that in the New Living Translation. Let us read. For the sin of this one man, Adam, caused death to rule over many. But even greater is God's wonderful grace and his gift of righteousness. For all who receive it will live in what? Triumph over life and death. Now put that in the TBT translation, please. Let's read. Death once held us in its grip, and by the blunder of one man, death reigned as what? King over humanity. But now, how much more are we held in the grip of grace and continue reigning as what? As what? As what? In what? In life. Enjoy our regal freedom through the gift of perfect righteousness in one and only what? Jesus. You may be seated. Hallelujah. Come on, everybody. In Christ, we rule as king. In Christ, God says in Christ. Y'all see it all in Christ. Hallelujah. Because you believe he's the Messiah, because you believe he's king, because you believe that God said we're going to rule and reign in life as king. Yeah. Hallelujah. He wants all of us in Christ because of his kingdom, and because when you start talking about kingdom, you're talking about rule. Come on, everybody. He wants all of us to rule as king. Hallelujah. Can I get amen on that? Amen. How many know God's hand is not short? God promised me personally, Philippians chapter 4, verse 19 and 20. Out of his abundance of wealth, God will do this. Isn't that right? Hallelujah. And look at Matthew 6:33, Amplified verse, that God will always do us good because we will seek first his kingdom. Come on, everybody. When his way is first place in your life, it will cause you to prosper supernaturally every single time. Listen to me very carefully. God wants each and every one of us to prosper what? Supernaturally. And if we're going to prosper supernaturally, we'll do what? Put God first. But if we're not going to prosper supernaturally, we don't have to put God first. Right. Amen. You can do like the world do. You can get in a rat race and just do what they does. Come on, everybody, and have what they have, or have just what? As much as they say you're going to have based on this. But God said, I want you to get it what? Supernaturally. Hallelujah. 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 Whatever your financial situation, don't depend on money to make you happy. Instead, use what you have for the Lord. No matter how much you earn, if you try to create happiness by accumulating wealth, you will never have enough. Look with me in Ecclesiastes chapter 5, verse 10. While you're putting on the board, let me just put this in your hearing. So how are you really handling your money, in faith or in fear? Is it faith or fear? And we talked about it earlier, because of fear been handed down to us and we have not repented, then we're handling our money by fear. We really are, y'all. If you're not handling your money by faith, you're handling it by what? Same F, but just two different words. Hallelujah. Look what it says. Again, let's stand and read. Ecclesiastes 5 and 10. Those who love money will never have enough. How meaningless to think that wealth brings what? True happiness. Let's put it over there in King James Version. He that loveth silver should not be satisfied with silver, nor he that loveth abundance will increase. This is also what? Vanity. What it was saying is, and thank you, be seated, it's not about having all that stuff and having it in abundance without God's love. If you don't have God's love first and you don't love him and fall in love with him, if your relationship is not deep and rich with God, then all that stuff is vanity. Amen. The Bible talked about, man, you're going to have all that stuff, and have all that land and all that inheritance and all that money in the bank, and when you die, a fool going to get it. Oh, hallelujah. I don't mean to be unkind when I say that, but hallelujah. Come on, everybody, you do all that and scrape and scruff and cuss and fuss over that land, over that money. Come on, everybody. Come on, everybody. And the Bible says when you die, a fool going to get it. Why? Because you didn't put God first. Hallelujah. You got all that stuff. All talk about your stuff. And man, this, and I can't get nobody this. And I never got, you know, he got cameras on this property. All he thought about his stuff. He can't get somebody own my stuff. Somebody trying to get my. How many know God can take care of that? Hallelujah. Yeah. Amen. He'll call people. Come on, your property. Pick up paper off of your property. Yeah. Hallelujah. I was walking by, I saw paper on your project. Came by and picked this up. Hallelujah. Yeah. What do you mean? Walking by, I saw paper on your project. Came by that God just prompted me to do it. Amen. 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 So what I want to encourage you, so it's all about, again, if I'm handling my money and stuff in faith, if I'm handling in faith, that means I have a deep relationship with God. And so let's increase our relationship with him. Let's fall in love with him more and more and more. Why? That we can release what God has given us in abundance. Someone said, how we view money comes from how we observe our parents view money. In other words, our personal financial values have been what influenced by the financial value held by our parents. So we said earlier. So some say that we will formulate our opinions and make judgments based upon how we handle money. If we handle money in fear, it's going to be based on that. If we handle in faith, it's going to be based on that. Any investment is always, listen to me very carefully, any investment is always an investment of yourself. In return for giving your life at your job, you receive what? Money. Hallelujah. I said hallelujah. So your investment is always what? Yourself. In every arena. So you mean tell me my life is only worth these dollars? Come on, everybody. Off to work I go. You work all those many hours and overtime, all that. That's your life. Your life is worth these dollars? Are you serious? Come on, if you're worried, I mean, it may be six figures. You mean your life is only worth six figures? Hello? But your life in Christ and doing those jobs. Come on, hallelujah. But that means that, you know, yeah, I got six figure plus. Come on, everybody. My family loves me. My wife loves me. My children love me. I'm there for my wife. I'm there for my, come on, everybody. We have time with her, vacation time together. We love on each other. We kissing each other. Ooh. Come on, everybody, that means that my wife going to suffer for this, my children going to suffer. You may have to do all that, to work all those hours for you just to get this little boy and all that kind of. No, you got to have time. You ain't got time to go to a little league game with them and play with them. Why? Because you're working. Yeah. And then you come home, you're so tired, soon your bottom hit the chair. Daddy worked hard. That's all you know. Daddy worked hard. All your daddy worked hard. All your daughter worked hard. Come on, everybody. No relationship. You don't know nothing. As a young man, you don't know what to do. So you're growing up, don't know what to do, how to handle a situation, because daddy who know how to handle it, he sleep. Come on, everybody. The wisdom of God that come from daddies, they sleep. Yeah, they're working. They're providing. But it's more. Your life is more than just six figure. Your life is, hallelujah, is that I'm passing on to the next generation. I care about the next. Come, hallelujah. Yeah. I care about them, hallelujah. I don't want to lose my spouse over no money. Hallelujah. And investment is always what? Investment of yourself. In return God wants to do what? He wants you to invest your money and show where your life is invested. So you know what? Again, people don't want to invest in the kingdom of God, so therefore they invest in this, they invest in that. They invest in this over here. They invest in themselves. And they, you know, when I mean they invest in themselves about what, they just all about self-centeredness now instead of investing in the kingdom of God. People don't do stuff about the kingdom of God because it's all about them. You know what the Bible said? If you love much, you'll what? Give much. How much you love God? How much you love the people of God? Let me tell you very clear. The Bible said, this is how the world going to know that you belong to me, is your love for one another. Come on, everybody. People say, man, I ain't going to church. It ain't about going to church. It's about my people. I love my people. Hallelujah. Amen. I love my peeps. Hallelujah. Amen. Come on, everybody. I can't wait to do it. I don't know. I had a service for my mom. Y'all know this. And man, I just saw all the people. Just joy. Amen. It's the people. Come on, everybody. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. But the devil don't want you to give with people. He don't want you to fellowship with people. He don't want you to love on people and give the gift that God. Remember, if you don't use what God has given, you're going to lose it. Come on, everybody. God wants you to use that gift and gain more what you have. Come on, everybody. Keep what you have and gain more. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So people, the devil won't get people out of place, and God has given a gift to be a blessing to the body of Christ. But the devil won't get you out of place that you can't be a blessing to us. It ain't about our personality. It ain't about this. No, I belong to God. He's my Lord. He's instructed me. And so guess what? You can talk crazy all you want. I'm going to say what God says. Hallelujah. 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 I'm going to keep saying what God says. I'm going to keep saying what God says. I don't care what you say. I'm going to keep saying what God says. Hallelujah. I'm not going to get twisted about you. I'm not going to get side bent about you. I'm going to love on you. Why? Because I'm going to let God use me to speak to you. Hallelujah. 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 Last time I checked, remember that prophet Isaiah? You remember the prophet Ezekiel? He walked around naked in the desert. Come on, he don't care what y'all say about him. Because God told him to do it. Come on, everybody. Hallelujah. We get all what people say this, they're going to do this and that. Who cares what they say? I'm obeying God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Why? Because now we got recording the scripture for God has used him mightily to what? To the body of Christ. And what I'm saying to you, God is going to use us mightily if we use what he's given us. Come on, everybody. And that is, I want to speak to the body of Christ. I want to be able to speak to them. I want to speak into their lives. I don't want to get side bent by nobody. I don't want to get nothing in my heart by nobody. Why? Because if I do, I'm not going to allow what God has given me to be expressed toward you. Hallelujah. You know, you may have a sausage head. That's okay. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Think about Mandus. Hallelujah. It's a good smoked sausage. Amen. Glory to God. I'm going to give you what you need. Hallelujah. You know, I can make some gumbo with that head. You know. You got to come on. You got to laugh. Come on, everybody. A merry heart do it good like a medicine. Isn't that right? So be encouraged. Hallelujah. Father, we just thank you, Lord Jesus, for your precious people. We thank you for what you're doing in their hearts and lives. We thank you, Lord God, that you brought them to this place this morning for we can enjoy each other. And Lord, even as we talked about finances and being financially free and talking about the other aspect of financial freedom, Lord God, that was a joy among us. And that means that God, that is joy means that we are connected by faith to you and all that you're doing. We thank you, Lord Jesus, that joy is an evident. It's the evidence that we have given in faith. Won't you stand on your feet with us this morning? Be so encouraged. You know, when you give and when God use you to give, that's a joy to come. That's a joy. And we thank you, Lord, that you have filled this environment with joy because, Lord God, your people give generously. Because you say the righteous give generously, Lord God. I thank you, Lord, for the tide opening the windows of heaven. And I thank you for all the financial tools that we have. But, Lord, it's about giving in faith that brings joy to us. And Lord, all of that means that our love for you and who you are and what you're all about cause all this, Lord God Almighty, to be a joy to us. And I thank you, Lord Jesus, that we can leave and go into marketplaces and go around our spiritual influence and let them see, Lord, the joy that floods our soul. It's not because of what's going on in the stock market, not going with the gasoline prices and all those kinds of things. It's about that God is using us to live from the inside out. the kingdom is ruling in us because our relationship with the Lord through Jesus Christ, we got joy, we got peace, we got love, we got patience, we got kindness. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. On top of it all, Lord, we have eternal life. To you, God Almighty, get all the glory, Father, that you're using us wherever we are. The bottom line is that that person who looking on, who experiencing the chaos in their lives, the struggles in their lives, they're looking at us for whatever arena in life. But Lord, the bottom line is, it's all about do they know Jesus as their Lord and Savior. And I thank you, Lord, the simplicity of the point of contact to be blessed will cause those who are really not, they say, Lord, I need you. Thank you, Lord Jesus, for using that in people's lives that they want to know you. Thank you, Lord, for raising us up and blessing us that we can be a blessing to others. Say, yes, you need Jesus. Not another dollar, but you need Jesus. And Father, I just thank you for it right now. Thank you, Lord Jesus. You remember the Lord Jesus, Peter was a fisherman, and Peter's beginning to fish, and Peter, he fished all night. But a prophetic word came and said, drop your nets down here. Where? Right here, dropping down on your right side of the boat. Not just anywhere, on the right side of the boat, he said. A prophetic word came on the right side because Peter obeyed a prophetic word and dropped down on the right. He said, Lord, we're professional. You're not a prophet. We're professional fishermen. You're a carpenter. You know about building stuff, but Jesus said, let down the net. He said, nevertheless, at your word, the prophetic word, I let it down. And when he let it down, how many of you know he caught a catch? Come on, but he was so excited about all that fish. And man, and all the partners came along, man, they all got fish. But Jesus said, what about, come on, everybody. Your abundance is connected to people. God is not about just blessing you with all that stuff. He wants you to be blessed, all that stuff, that you could be a blessing to people. Then what he says, this day you should be what? Fishermen of men. Come on, everybody, that means that I want you to live on revelation concerning what? Being a fisherman of men. I don't want you to just use your regular old talent, your regular old skills. I want you to be anointed. And Father, I thank you for what you do in the hearts and lives of your precious people, that Lord God, they will reflect you wherever they go. I thank you for it, Father, that people are coming to the kingdom of God because their lifestyle in you. In Jesus' name, amen. God bless you this morning. We love you so very much. Thank you for coming and allowing us to speak into your heart and share what God is doing in our lives. And our hospitality team has prepared.
Thank you for watching. If you have any questions or concerns, feel free to contact us at westgatechurchla@gmail.com. For any upcoming events, please visit our website, westgatechurchla.org. Thank you and have a blessed day.